What is going on, you guys? Welcome back to another episode of the Winnipeg Jets Franchise Mode. Last video, we made some huge trades, and we got basically a brand new second line. What I mean by brand new second line, I mean a new right winger on the second line. And our team's looking pretty good. I like the way our team looks. Christian Vasilainen's actually breaking through, cracking the roster now. Same with Jansen Harkins. Joseph Quick starting to move up there. He could be a second liner anytime now. And Jarrett McCann cracked the lineup. And Oliver Bjorkstrand's our new second line sniper. We're paying him some pretty good money, so he needs to score some goals this season, some pretty big goals. He's got William Nylander, so he should be good. And Nikolaj Ehlers, who's kind of the... I don't know about Nikolaj Ehlers, man. Like, he's not growing at all. And, I mean, I guess he's producing. He could be doing better, but you know what? You can't really blame him. He had almost a career year last year. He can't really get past over 35 points. So, you know what? I'm not upset with him. 48 points, my bad. I was looking at an assist. He had 48 points. That's not that bad. He can't break 52. He's having a pretty good season last year. So, I'm not going to complain about him. I know there was a comment on the video from Marks Carlson's. You're seeing it on the screen now. And it says, trade Vlasic and Jacob Trouba. That would solve some issues for maybe next season when we have younger defensemen coming up. But right now, trading both of them is a bad idea. I would love to move Mark Edward Vlasic's contract before the end of the season, because he does have 5 years left on it. He's 33, though. He's in his prime, basically. I wouldn't mind getting rid of that contract, but considering we just got rid of Dustin Byfuglien, I don't feel like it's necessary. Now, moving Jacob Trouba would be more realistic to do, but if we're going to move a defenseman, we might as well move Mark Edward Vlasic. He's older, he's 33, and he's got 6 years left, I believe. Yeah, 5 years left. That's a crazy contract. I still can't believe we signed him for that. And because Darcy Passani needs to be playing top four, and Logan Stanley's a top six. So I do have a trade worked out for Mark Edward Vlasic. We are going to move him right now. So you did inspire me to look around the league for some trades, and I did find a valuable trading partner for him. And we are going to move him right now because as the morale for the team may go to crap, it's going to help our team. We're also going to check free agency, make sure there's no big free agents left. No, there's not at all. Okay, so just making sure, because I just look back at the video to see what I did last video, and I saw there's some big free agents defensemen. I was checking if any of them were still there. Anyways, we are going to call up the GM from Boston. And we're going to tell them that we are interested in trading them Mark Edward Vlasic. They don't necessarily want him, but they're one of very few teams that can support his cap. Like, Anaheim can support his cap. We could get Ryan Getzlaf, but again, we don't need Ryan Getzlaf. We could get Bergeron, but we don't need Bergeron. We want a defenseman in return who can play the bottom defenseman pairing minutes. So, a top six defender. And I was looking at Brandon Carlo. Now, I know what you're saying. Ooh, Boston wouldn't trade Brandon Carlo in real life, but in the game, he's only 82 overall. He's 23 years old. He has low top four potential. And he's listed as top six. He's got 1 year left on his deal at like 1.010. So it's a very tiny contract compared to Vlasic's. But if you look what Boston's lacking, it's a top defenseman. We have Josh Morrissey. They have a Zobero, Jakub Jibero. He's a top four defenseman. He's 85. Although he may be the future of defensive core now that Big Z's gone, they need somebody else. I wouldn't mind having Brandon Carlo, even though he may not be playing next season. I mean, even Alex Petrovic wouldn't be bad. But how many? He's got 3 years left on his deal. I want someone who we could get rid of this season if they need to go. I mean, Kevin Miller's not bad either, but 3 years. Brandon Carlo's got 1 year on his deal. He could be decent. He may turn out to be nothing. So we're going, this trade right now would go through. I'm 99% sure this trade would go through, unless they'd be unwilling to take the cap of Vlasic, which they can handle the cap of Vlasic. He's 89 overall. It's not bad. Now, I do want something else out of this. So let's see if they're willing to get rid of anybody. Just Bergeron and Backetts. I would take Bergeron if he had 1 year left and we had a center spot, but not only do we not have a center spot, he has 2 years left. There's no point in taking him. Now, we could take him, play William Nylander on the wing, and then trade Nikolaj Ehlers, but why would we trade Nikolaj Ehlers? I don't know, man. My mind's just telling me to trade Nikolaj Ehlers. I don't want to, though. I don't want to blow it. Actually, you know what? Screw it. I want a Stanley Cup this season. We're going to go after... No, because he's older and he's going to lose morale. I mean, he's going to lose... I mean, it's 2 years, man. He's 35. Can he really go down that much in 2 years? He's going to make... He'll maintain his overall this season. He'll retire, though. That trade would go through like this. We're getting rid of a contract for Bergeron, and I'm sure they'd be willing to take 25% of his salary, which is 1.7 million for 2 years, and get rid of Brendan Carlo. This trade would most likely go through, but we can make this trade huge. What if we throw in Nikolaj Ehlers? No, they do not want Nikolaj Ehlers. So there's no point in throwing him on here. Why would we give them two players they don't want? Now, Bergeron can score goals. I do know that. I did look at his stats because I did consider trading for him, and I realized there's no point to. He can... last season, he did struggle the last three seasons, so that's the problem. But he's a 30-goal scorer the seasons before that, but he did struggle the last three seasons. Now, would Ryan Getzlaf be a better trade partner for Vlasic? Getzlaf has 1 year left at 30. He's 35 years old. How's his goal scoring been? 20 goals per season. That's a little better than Bergeron. He's dropped off quite a bit. He had that 130-goal season. But you know what? Playing next to William Nylander, how are his faceoffs? 89. So he's a pretty good... he's still way better than William Nylander in the faceoff, but he's a first-line forward. We'd be playing him on the second line. I don't want to do that. Bergeron's listed as a second liner. I'd rather take on Bergeron's contract for... I'd rather take on Bergeron's contract 2 years at 6.8 if they were to retain, as I said, 15% or 25%. If they were to retain 25% of his contract, I will be extremely comfortable making this deal. Now, I know what you're saying. You can't just dump Nikolaj Ehlers like that, man. He's a good forward. Winnipeg Jets drafted him a while back ago. He still has the low elite. He's only 24. Here's the thing. Joseph Quick is moving up. Christian Vasilainen is moving up. He's being pushed out. Look at this. Let's go to the left wingers. You have Brendan Lemieux, who's right there. That's sort by overall. I'll let you guys see that picture. Patrick Laine, Christian Vasilainen, Brendan Lemieux. They're moving up. Now, Keane, Matt Kern could definitely be there next season. Fourth liner. For sure. Now, given right wingers, we have a surplus of right wingers. Nikolaj Ehlers is a right winger, not a left winger. See, we're playing him in the wrong position anyways. So, William Nylander could play left wing. So, Nikolaj Ehlers, I mean, look at these right wings, man. Bjorkstrand, he's obviously not taking his place. Blake Wheeler. Joseph Quick is about to be a second liner, pushing Nikolaj Ehlers back down. And look at these prospects we have coming up. We have Patan, which he's probably not going to do anything though, but Zuboff, Noah Douglas, Marshall Duncan. I mean, these guys are high-quality prospects. That could be these two, Zuboff and Douglas, could be NHL-ready next season for the fourth line. Nick Patan could already play fourth line if we needed him. Nikolaj Ehlers is a surplus, man. We're wasting him here in Winnipeg. He hasn't grown at all. Like, when we first started, he was 84 overall. He's still a 84 overall. That's what I'm failing to figure out, man. He's not growing at all. I told you we were going to rebuild the second line, and it starts now. We are rebuilding the second line. Nikolaj Ehlers will be thrown into this deal, so that raises the value quite a bit. I actually want Boston. Yeah, 25%. Nikolaj Ehlers will be thrown on there. And we also... So, trying to think here. So, our first line would be Laine, Scheifele, Wheeler. Our second line would be Nylander, Bergeron, Bjorkstrand. I would like to take on a prospect. We're already. I know for sure we're taking Brendan Carlo. He's gonna be thrown in the deal for sure. He's gonna be thrown up in the mix for sure. Brendan Carlo. The value's on our side, guys. We could take somebody else. And not only this is gonna free up a lot of cap for next season when you do have to re-sign some big name people. If we do have any big name people coming up in free agency. I don't necessarily want to take another defenseman. We don't necessarily have the room for anymore. That's why we traded Dustin Byfuglien. We didn't have any room. I wouldn't mind taking an AHL defenseman, though, maybe for prospects. Do they have, like, any goalies they'd be willing to get rid of? Corey Crawford, we don't need him. Malcolm Subban would be nice as a backup goalie, but why? We have Connor Hellebuyck, Hellebuck. We don't need Malcolm Subban, even though Malcolm Subban, he's not going to get any better, let's be honest. He's probably going to max out 85. Who all do you guys want to get? Just them two, man. I mean, draft picks. They're not really necessarily interested in giving away a first. What about a second? Actually, I really think I could squeeze a first out of this. Squeeze a first, and then we would throw in a... We really don't have any draft picks to throw in. That's why I want a first. We have nothing. I feel like this would go through as is. Bergeron, basically, for Ehlers. Vlasic for Carlo. And a first. Is Patrice Bergeron the new... Let me make sure he's a second liner. He is. Okay. Is Patrice Bergeron the newest second line center of the Winnipeg Jets? No. Okay. The value have... Okay, so they do not want to give off... No, they do not want to give away their first. Let's take a second. This would go through. This is going through. Yes, trade accepted. I maybe could have squeaked a third out of there. Now, I know what you guys are saying. Whoa, man. You just ruined the team's morale. It's going to completely suck now. Not necessarily. I have a master plan, guys. Trust me. Just bear with me here. Let's do this. Patrice Bergeron is going to go right here. Where's he at? Bergeron. He's 88. You know what? That's fine. Let's do this. Okay. I want William Nylander right here, and I want Patrice Bergeron as center, substituting all lines. Now, defensively, it is going... We're just going to hit best line and see what happens. Okay, so they have Bergeron on the first line, really. See, Mark Scheifele... I want Mark Scheifele on the first line. That's for sure. Now, Bjorkstrand... You know what? We're going to try him on the first line. Yeah, we're going to try Bjorkstrand on the first line with Lane and Scheifele. Let's see if we can get some goal scoring going, guys. I want some high-powered offense going. Now, here's what I want. I want Nylander here, Brendan Lemieux here, Harkins there, because Harkins is listed as a third liner. I want to see how Christian Vasilainen does on the third line. That looks good. Defense, Josh Morrissey, Tyler Myers. See, this is already looking better. Now, I know what you're saying. Okay, the defense is weaker now, but you know what? Darcy Persani can grow now. He could be at 87 before the end of the season if he grows correctly. Jacob Trouba is in the hot seat, man, because he's been doing terrible when it comes to point scoring. I understand he's a defenseman, but 8.6 and 8 points in a season, that's not very good. And then 13 and 14, okay, I understand 20 to 14 points, but, like, come on, man. You have to be in double digits. That's where... I mean, look at someone like Josh Morrissey. He's obviously better than Jacob Trouba. But look at him. 14. Ah, you know what? It's not that bad. Okay. I need to be lighter on my defenseman. Tyler Myers isn't that bad of a defenseman either. He's actually almost in the teens. Like, putting up 20 points almost per season. Tyler Myers is definitely staying. He's got 2 years left. He's going to be here for those 2 years for sure. And, you know, this is going to help us out. Because in the AHL, we do have some prospects that could come up, including the Green Bean line. They could be NHL ready next season. Fingers crossed, guys. Now, let me go through the power play, make sure everything's good, and then we'll get some simulation going. All right, guys, because Dustin Byfuglien was traded, we do have to name a brand new alternate captain, and I already know who it's going to be, and that is the very young Josh Morrissey. He's earned it. He's worked hard for this team. I was considering giving it to Jacob Trouba, but Josh Morrissey is obviously going to be the face of our defensive core. So he has earned it. So here we go, guys. This is a very important season for us. That's why we acquired Bergeron. I expect big numbers from Bergeron. I want to see at least 40 points. if I don't see at least 40 points from Bergeron, we failed as a team. I failed as a GM, and I should probably just give up this. But you know what? Let's go ahead and sim. And I'm going to sim past preseason, and I'll let you guys know when the season starts. All right, guys, we went 1-4-1 in preseason. That's extremely bad. Okay. I didn't expect for it to be that bad, but you know what? That's okay, I guess. I mean, it's preseason. What do we care? I do know the locker room chemistry is at a low. Same with the fan happiness. Probably because we were bounced first round and all these trades we made probably stirred up some fans out there because Dustin Byfuglien's gone. And now Nikolaj Ehlers and Marc-Edouard Vlasic. But you know what? They need to understand we're going to be a great team this season. Here we go, the LA Kings. We are going to slow sim the very first game of the season. LA versus the Winnipeg Jets. Very first game of the season. Here we go, first period. Oliver Bjorkstrand and Patrice Bergeron. Look at that. Two off-seasons, big acquisitions we made. Both scored a goal in the first period. The fans have breathed their sigh of relief. Second period. Jarrett McCann gets one. His first game in the NHL for the Winnipeg Jets. Third period. Okay, so they ruined Eric Comrie's shutout, but you know what? That's a good game. We got goals from both the people we traded for and someone who we grew in the AHL last season. That I call that game a good one. A good start to the season. Of course, we do slow sim some Central Division games. I did notice some people are unhappy with me slow simming a bunch of games, so I'm not going to slow sim as much as I normally do. Here we go. St. Louis Blues, first period, Ivan Barbashk. Second period, we have our backup goalie in, and it looks like he's having a tough night. Third period, Jacob Trouba gets one, and 3-1 victory for the St. Louis Blues. So basically what just happened to LA just happened to us. Now we have the Colorado Avalanche. We are not going to slow sim that game. We're actually going to skip straight to that Minnesota game, and we're going to play the third period of it. I believe that's one of our owner goals, to beat Minnesota in our opening week. Or in the home game against Minnesota. Let me check, actually, to make sure that's what it is before I... Secondary, yeah. Okay, so beat Minnesota, the Minnesota Wild. Let's slow sim to the game. I really want to be above 500 team going after the first month. So here we go. Colorado, 6-3 loss. That's terrible, guys. Come on. Arizona Coyotes, 4-0 loss. That's three games in a row. This season's going to be rough. I feel it now. Wow, we've lost four straight games. That's bad. We're 1-4. That's terrible, man. Here we go, Minnesota Wild. We're playing the third period. Let's get a win here. I don't want to lose. We need a win here. First period, William Nylander and Derek Brassard. Second period. Okay, William Nylander and Jacob Trouba and Nino Niederreiter. Let's hop into this. All right, here we are, guys. And in the faceoff circle, Mark Scheifele is going to win the faceoff. Tyler Myers is going to get that pass to Bjorkstrand, who's going to shoot that one low to Devin Dubnyk, but Devin Dubnyk was able to make the save. Mark Scheifele is going to try to play the puck as Minnesota carries it back in. Tyler Myers with a big hit right there. He uses his reach to get there. Patrick Laine, looking to have a big season this year, is trying to get the puck but unable to acquire it. And he's having a hard time here as basically Minnesota is just killing the time. Winnipeg does have the 3-2 lead here. Mark Scheifele gets hit. Spurgeon carries the puck. Gets at the Brodin, who gets it back to, I don't know who that is. And then Tyler Myers lays the body. Mark Scheifele has the puck. Gets it to Bjorkstrand, who gets bodied. Mark Scheifele chasing down Jonas Brodin, but nothing there. And he gets hit. Kyle Turris. You know, Niederreiter. Open. Ooh, he hits the post. That was an open shot. That should have been a goal right there. Bergeron, now in the Winnipeg Jets jersey, fires that one, but Devin Dubnyk with the big save. Blake Wheeler, Zach Parise has the puck. Blake Wheeler plays Zach Parise. William Nylander now has the puck. William Nylander speeds into the offensive zone, and he goes forehand, backhand, but Devin Dubnyk poke checks it away before he's able to finish the deke. Kyle Turris carries it in Winnipeg's end. Stewart gets the puck, gives that one to Kyle Turris, but Bergeron, one of the best two-way defenders. Why did William Nylander stop skating there? That's stupid. He stopped skating. That's so dumb. I think he ran into the ref. Blake Wheeler gets to puck to Christian Vasilainen. Christian Vasilainen speeds into the offensive zone. Christian Vasilainen looking, trying to go 5-hole. Devin Dubnyk says, no, not today. Persani Trying to play A to Man. Parise, Broussard. Ooh, that could have been a break right there for Minnesota, but nothing. Joseph Quick looking for a big breakout season this year. Gets that back to Pisani. Gets it to Tyler Myers, who fans on it. Gets it back to Pisani. Puts that one on net. That one's tipped wide, though. There's a pass. Jensen Harkins on nothing. Unable to make anything go in. Joseph Quick puts that one in there. Joseph Quick giving Winnipeg a 4-2 lead. Minnesota fans are nodding their head, but it's still possible, guys. There's 7 minutes in the game. Dumba has the puck. Hansel, Lowry, the former Winnipeg Jet, gets bodied by his former teammate in Jacob Trouba. Adam Lowry carries this puck in. He's looking to have a good night. Oliver Bjorkstrand gets that one to Christian Vasilainen. Unbelievable. Christian Vasilainen speeds in, gets that one back to Bjorkstrand. Dumba able to break that pass up, though. And this one may go for icing as Brendan Carlo speeds for it. And that's going to be icing on Winnipeg. Bad time for icing as the Scheifele-Laine line gets on the ice. Patrick Laine looking to score some goals here. He's been struggling this season so far. Clutterbuck. Patrick Laine gets the hit on Clutterbuck. Logan Stanley corrals the puck, though. But Dumba able to take that puck. Adam Lowry, Patrick Laine poke checks it away. But that's going to be a penalty upon Patrick Laine as he trips somebody. Brett Howden out there for the penalty kill here. He loses the draw. Ooh. Block shot, I believe that's Brendan Lemieux right there. Block shot. Here we go. Brett Howden gets that one up. Brendan Lemieux skates in. Gets that one. The Brett Howden, remember, they were that phenomenal rookie line from last season. They were separated this year, though, because of Christian Vasilainen. And Brett Howden and Brendan Lemieux has now played on the fourth line. Brendan Lemieux looking to prove people that he's better than a fourth liner. Robbed by Devin Dubnyk. Unbelievable. He just shut the door right there. Oh, Jonas Brodin off the turnover. Derek Brassard, Nino Niederreiter. Ooh, he misses the hit. He misses the check. And he gets taken out by Josh Morrissey. Brett Howden gets that one over to Patrick Laine, who's looking to score a goal out of the penalty box. Out of the penalty box, Patrick Laine unable to bury that one there. That's not good at all. Patrick Laine, no luck this season. Nino Niederreiter having a hard time getting past Persani right there. Jacob Trouba. The net is empty for Minnesota. Devin Dubnyk is on the bench, and they will get the extra attacker. Patrick Laine is out there now. If he scores the empty net goal, that'd be huge for his morale, as he's been having a hard time scoring. What a poke check by Jacob Trouba. Saved what could have been a one-time opportunity, which could have been a huge chance for a goal. Patrick Laine has the puck here. He gets hit. Should have passed it there. I know he's looking for a goal. He should have passed it, though. Would have been the smartest thing to do. He's frustrated that he's having a hard time scoring this season so far. He's looking to get some goal scoring started. Jonas Brodin with a shot right there. There we go. Here's Patrick Laine. Patrick Laine speeds past the defender. Unable to corral that puck. He's poking away at that puck. He really wants that empty net goal. He's unable to, and his shift should be about over. Oh, wait. He's still out there. He's still out there. Patrick Laine has the puck. Patrick Laine got the puck, and he shoots. And Patrick Laine scores, and that's going to be the game right there. Patrick Laine gets a goal. 5-2 Winnipeg, 7 seconds left. The fans have breathed a sigh of relief for Patrick Laine, as he's been struggling with goal scoring this season. That's his first goal of the season. Had to get the monkey off his back somehow this season, and that was the way he did it. Just like that, Patrick Laine scoring a huge goal here. And he's going to, hopefully this season, he'll have more goals than that. Bergeron's on the ice for the faceoff. As always, Bergeron wins the faceoff, wins the draw. Blake Wheeler's going to skate into the zone. Blake Wheeler takes a shot. That goes in. 6-2 Winnipeg with 1 second left. Devin Dubnyk stopped playing. He just wants to go home. I don't blame him. What a hard night for him. As the Winnipeg Jets will take this game. Considered a blowout now because of that score. Ladies and gentlemen, your Winnipeg Jets have beat the Minnesota Wild in our first meeting of the season. So we're going to slow send the next game just to make sure nobody gets their revenge on us. Our AHL team is 4-1, by the way, the Mooses. So let's get this game going. Here we go, first period. Scoreless in Minnesota, second period. Josh Morrissey, and then third period, Bergeron and Adam Lowry. Wow, the guy we released gets a goal on us. He shows that he still wants to be a Winnipeg Jet at heart, and he may be a little salty over him being released. So, we're about to come to the end of the first month, and it was a terrible first month. Let's finish a 500 team against the Chicago Blackhawks. Come on, here we go. We're in Chicago, so they do have home ice advantage. Let's go. Big game right here. First period, scoreless. Second period, Jonathan Toews and Patrick Laine gets one. There we go. The goal scoring has begun for Patrick Laine. Third period. Ooh, we destroyed. Eric Comrie is kind of iffy this season so far. I don't want to blame our defense. I don't want to blame Eric Comrie, but we've been having a lot of goals scored against us this season. That may need to be addressed before the end of the season, before the trade deadline, that is. Because we're having a hard time right now keeping the puck out of the back of the net. And if we want to make playoffs, if we want to win a Stanley Cup this season, we got to do better than that. Okay, let's scout OHL for forwards for 2 weeks. Here we go, Philadelphia. Actually, no, let's check to see the goal scoring. Maybe I should split some of the lines up. Maybe put Bjorkstrand on the second line and put Wheeler back in the first line. Mark Scheifele is leading the team with 8 points. How's the goal scoring, though? That's what I need to make sure is good. Bergeron with 6 points. That's great. Patrick Laine, 5. Only 2 goals. Eh, it's not terrible. Oliver Bjorkstrand of 5. Blake Wheeler of 5. William Nylander of 4. 3 goals, though. That's pretty good. Jacob Trouba of 3 goals. There we go. 3 goals for 3 points, man. That's not that bad. Darcy Pisani keeping up right there with him. Josh Morrissey, only 1 point. It was a goal. Christian Vasilainen, 1 point. You know, it's still early in the season. You can't really expect everybody to get a bunch of points. But you know what? As long as our first and second lines producing, we need more goals, basically. I may have to split up Bjorkstrand and Laine. Maybe put Bjorkstrand on the second line and put Blake Wheeler back on the first line. I don't know. I mean, yeah, let's do that. Let's put, you know, yeah, let's go one more month like this, though, like it is now, and then we'll evaluate it, and depending on how that goes, then we'll put Bjorkstrand on the second line if we do need a change. So, basically, we'll slow sim this game against St. Louis. So, here we go. Philadelphia Flyers in Philly. We will win 2-0. There we go. Let's win all the games this month, guys. Dallas, 1-0 win. There we go. It's a Central Division rival. That's huge. The Nashville Preds, we will beat them for, wow. Okay. So Nashville does end our goalless our streak. I cannot keep up with the simulation right now. Talking. My mind's all over the place today. But we went 3 games without a goal being scored on us. And then we lost Nashville. We beat Minnesota, but then we lost 2 back-to-back games, which kind of sucks. But you know what? You win some, you lose some, guys. It's still early in the season. I want to solidify us as a winning team, though. There's a 4-1 win over the Edmonton Oilers. Pittsburgh Penguins, 1-0 loss. Ouch, that hurts. You can't blame goalie for that one. And we're going to slow sim this game against the St. Louis Blues. Here we go. First period, Oliver Bjorkstrand. Second period, William Nylander and Yuri Laterra, third period. Okay, why do we always choke in the third period when I slow him? Come on, guys. First against Chicago, now against St. Louis. Third period's hard for us, guys. We always choke in the third period. We got to work on that. Let's repair this stuff, and then we'll get back to simulation. All right, all that stuff's repaired. Let's keep it going. Let's slow sim against Chicago. Hopefully, we can win that game. I mean, we're 8-10. I want to finish the month. I want to at least get to be above 500 team. Anaheim Ducks, we beat them 4-2. Great. Okay, Chicago, let's get some goals going here. I want to see Laine score a few goals in this game. First period, second period, third period. There we go. Josh Morrissey, Joseph Quick, and Patrice Bergeron. Bergeron's actually producing really well for us, and I'm okay with it, man. If Bergeron wants to put up a lot of points for us, I'm not going to complain at all. So we are a 500 team as of right now. Let's finish this month above 500. 3 games above 500 is great. Let's go on a 4-game winning streak. Come on, Colorado Avalanche. Well, actually a 5-game winning streak, technically. Colorado, we will lose to them 3-1. They end our dreams of doing that. Edmonton Oilers, we will beat them 5-2. There we go. So we're a 500 team. This game against Dallas will determine if we're above a 500 team or below a 500 team, which is pretty, I mean, it's still early. I'm not really worried about it. They're having a decent season as well. Let's get this win here. First period, Klingberg and Lane, second period. Lemieux and Berglund, third period. Oh my god, okay. We need to stop blowing up in the third period. Like, I don't know what it is. Like, we cannot score goals in the third period. If hockey was two periods long, we'd be undefeated. But, come on. That's ridiculous. There's no point for that. Let's check out to see how the lines are doing, and maybe if I should move some people around. Move the lines up. Ah, we're next. I think we're last in the Central Division. It's still too early to look at the standings. We're dead last in the Central Division. It's really close. We've played almost more games than most of them, though. So, well, similar to games than most of them. I don't know what to do with this team, guys. I want to blame the goaltender, but you can't do that. Scheifele and Bergeron leading the team in points. Jensen Hodkins, look at him. He's right there, too, 13. Joseph Quick, where's the goal scoring at? Where are our goal scorers? Bergeron, Lane, Nylander. Where is Borgstrand? He hasn't scored a goal since last time I stopped simulation. Okay, he's going to go back on the second line. Look at Vasilainen, man. He's scoring some goals, too. I had some people comment saying he was a bust. He's not a bust. He's doing pretty good. That's not bad for third line minutes. That's not bad at all. Is there anybody doing terrible? I mean, yeah, our defensive defensemen don't have goals. Wow, big deal. Joseph Quick's doing really good down there in the third line. 13 points. Okay, Borgstrand's going to go to the second line with Bergeron, who seems to be producing really well. I'm going to put Blake Wheeler, because Blake Wheeler is not... He's having a hard time scoring some goals. We'll put him with Mark Scheifele. He tends to score some good goals with Mark Scheifele on the ice. And we'll just mix the lines up like that, and we should be good. Hopefully. In theory, we should be good. Because we need to start winning games. If we don't start winning games, then this isn't going to be a good offseason for us at all. So, let's do this. Borgstrand, you're going to play here. Bergeron, Blake Wheeler goes there. William Nylander, he's not doing bad. So, William Nylander actually put scoring quite a few goals next to Patrice Bergeron. See, I like this. When your top six is all over, well, 86 or over, Patrick Laine is still really young. It's an awesome line, man. I mean, Mark Scheifele's good. Blake Wheeler, he's got 2 years left on his deal. Borgstrand's got three. Bergeron has two. And Nylander has three. I don't know where the goal scoring is going on against us. I mean, our defense looks pretty solid. I don't know what's... Why are we giving up so many goals? Is it... Eric Comrie? Is that who it is? I mean, he's got a great save percentage. Is it Connor Helbuyck? Or Hellebuck? Yeah, it's Connor Hellebuck. Okay, that's why. That explains it. Oh, it's a backup goalie. When in doubt, blame the backup goalie. So you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to turn auto goalie rotation off. And we're going to see... We're going to play Eric Comrie for a full month. And we're going to see... Because injuries are off. We are going to see if that's what's doing it. I know this is unrealistic to have auto goalie rotation off, but hey, some of the trades we make are unrealistic. So, it's franchise mode. So, auto goalie rotation off. So, that should help us out quite a bit. And we'll keep Eric Comrie in there, and hopefully he racks up some wins and grows a little bit. Because having an 86 overall goalie is kind of hurting us, I guess. We're going to go through one more month. What month is it? December or January? It's December. Let's take it to the All-Star game. Which is in February. Yeah, let's take it to the All-Star. No, yeah, we're going to take it to the All-Star game. Why not? So, we're going to slow... Of course, we're going to slow sim the game against Boston. We're going to slow sim against Columbus. In Columbus to see if Borgstrand does something. Alright, guys, we did lose in overtime to Tampa Bay. There is a player morale meeting going on, and it's William Nylander. When you're as good as me, recent performances like these are just the norm. Now, he's a common person. I remember that from the beginning of the when we first traded for him, he likes the common response. So here we go. Let's continue simulation. As I said, we're going to slow sim the games against Columbus to see if Bjorkstrand puts up some points against his old team. Here we go. First off, we do have New Jersey in New Jersey. They're having a terrible season. And we beat them 7-4. There's our goal scoring. It just explodes right there. St. Louis, they're having a great season. And we beat them 4-2. There we go. Maybe swapping these lines around like this is great. Giving Eric Comrie all the starts, maybe what's doing it. 3-2 lost in Vancouver. Colorado, we got to win these Central Division games. 5-4 overtime loss. Come on. We can't win Central Division games. That's what's bothering me. We're not going to make playoffs if we can't have high Central Division standings. That's for sure. Here we go. Columbus Blue Jackets. First period. William Nylander, Mark Scheifele, Sam Bennett. Wow. First Adam Lowry, now Sam Bennett. They just are out to get us, man. Second period. Nick Foligno, third period. There we go. Finally, we don't choke. Bjorkstrand gets one. Patrick Laine, Scheifele, and Bergeron. For once, we didn't choke in the third period. We actually exploded some goal scoring. And we do play Columbus again. We are going to slow sim that game. Let's get the simulation going here, guys. I want to rack up some wins here. Nashville Predators, big Central Division game right here. We need to make sure we win this game. If we don't win this game, we're going to fall low to the standings early. And that's, I don't want to play catch-up. Come on. We win it 4-3. Great. Okay, awesome. As long as we win the Central Division games, we should be good. We beat the Kings in the shootout round. Carolina, they have a pretty good team now. We will lose to them in the shootout round, but we did get a point. And here we are against the Columbus Blue Jackets again. Let's see if Bjorkstrand score a goal against them again. Here we go. First period. Okay. Patrice Bergeron, second period. There we go. Bergeron and Scheifele, Boone Jenner. Third period. Dombinsky. And we will take that game 2-3. Bergeron's actually producing quite well. Bergeron and William Nylander are having a great season for us, guys. We were going to slow sim the game against Boston. That's what it was. So, okay, Dallas is up next. A Central Division game. We have to make sure we win this game. It's very important to us. I know it's still early in the season. Well, it's starting to be where the stand-ins do matter. Big game here. 3-1 loss. That sucks. We need to at least get points out of that. We're starting to become a winning team again. And we're going to lose 3 straight. Watch. We're going to lose 2 more straight and become 500 again. Because that's how much franchise mode hates me. San Jose. 6-4 win. Finally. Okay, good. St. Louis, we will slow sim this game. I'm trying not to slow sim too many games because a lot of you guys don't like it. First period. Second period. Blake Wheeler and Poland. Third period. Christian Vastalainen and Jarrett McCann. Finally, we don't see. Now we're not choking in the third period ever since I moved the lines around. I'm going to keep them how they are, though, because we're starting to win games like this, and I like it. We're just definitely slow sim the game against Boston. We should slow sim against Toronto, see if William Nylander does something. He's been here for a few seasons now, though, so he's probably score anyways. He's used to that. Just destroy Toronto. They're probably going to wreck us now that I said that. 5-3 win. Let's go. I'm sure William Nylander at least had a point there. Okay, Boston Bruins, let's do some slow simulation here, and then we'll finish out the month. First period, why did I do that? 1-1, Blake Wheeler and Gudas. Was that 20 seconds in? I believe it was. Second period, William Nylander. Third period, Morsi and Nylander. David Krejci gets one. What a third period right there. Gives us the win. And come on, we're winning games now, guys. This is where I believe the team was going to be heading into this season. That was Mark Scheifele bobblehead night, too, by the way. Mark Scheifele is actually having a pretty good season for us. I normally say he struggles with points, which he didn't last season, but he's actually starting to put up a lot of points. We don't need trades, man. We made a lot of trades in the offseason. Ooh, shootout round loss. Come on. Those Central Division games is what's going to kill us in the standings. I know that for sure. Arizona, come on. We can beat Arizona. 3-2 loss. LA, 2-0 loss. Come on, don't drop games like this. Don't you dare. 4-2 win against Tampa Bay. Great. Okay. Chicago, big Central Division game here. They're not having a too good season. We beat them 3-1. Ottawa, which they're okay team. We lose them in overtime. Carolina, they're a pretty good team. We beat them in overtime. Washington, they're a decent team as well. We beat them. New York, they are a really good team. And we will lose them, obviously. And Chicago is up next. Look at our AHL team, guys. They're 31-10-3. That's great. Let's scout for forwards 2 weeks. Here we go against Chicago. We should get the win here. as I say that, we're probably going to lose. 6-2 win. There we go. Our goal scoring is alive. It's alive and well. We lose in the shootout to Ottawa. Our goal scoring is alive and well, guys. Alive and well. We are number three in the Central Division. We went from last to three. Look at Mark Scheifele, 40 points. 10 points under a point per game player. I'm not going to complain about that. Where's our goal scoring at? Bergeron, Nylander, Lane. Where's Borkstrand? Ah, come on, Borkstrand. You're struggling to score goals. I was afraid of this. You know what? 7 goals? You know what? That's not bad. That's not bad. You have 27 assists. It may be your line mates carrying you, but you know what? I'll take that. Bergeron was a great pickup, guys. Because he's getting William Nylander going, and that's exactly what we need. Patrick Laine is on pace for another great goal season. He's already on pace for another 30-goal season if he keeps it up. Actually, he's on pace for another 20-goal season. I don't know. I think he can break 30 goals. I think he can break 30 goals this season. If anybody can do it, it can be Patrick Laine. Mark Scheifele, 12 goals. 40 points. That's great for Mark Scheifele. He's definitely going to surpass 74 points this season. For sure. Hopefully, at the rate he's going now, if he keeps this up, he'll definitely break it. I don't think he's going to reach his goal total from last season. He'll come close, though. That's for sure. Mark Scheifele's actually having a really good season for us. Jansen Harkins, this dude is a beast, man. Look at that. In his NHL debuted season, he's already 24 points. Brendan Lemieux's doing really good on the fourth line. Josh Morrissey, man, 16 points. Blake Wheeler, let me sort it by points. Okay, there we go. William Nylander, Blake Wheeler, Joseph Quick, 87 overall. He's still a third liner, best third liner in the league. He's 87 overall. That's exactly what we need, is a depth third liner like that. Jansen Harkins, Jarrett McCann, 21 points on the fourth line. That's what I'm talking about, man. Brendan Lemieux, Brett Halden, Christian Vesalainen, Josh Morrissey, Jacob Trouba, Tyler Myers, Persani, Logan Stanley, and Brandon Carlo. So, guys, I think doing what I said, leaving Eric Comrie in as goalie, was the best idea we could have done. No offense to Helbuick or Hellebuck, or however you say his stupid name. Eric Comrie is the guy. In 44 games, he's won 24. 0.93 save percentage, that's awesome. 4 shutouts on the season. He's only 25. He still has some room to grow. I'm really hoping he gets at least to 88. Let's hope, fingers crossed. He's got 3 years left on that small contract, and then we're going to pay him some big money if he gets good. I mean, because we do have some rookies that could catch up to him. Like Christian Heljanko, he's on pace to be a really good goalie. Okay. Because I turned all the goalie rotation off. I have to give Christian Heljanko the starts again. That's not good. I'm surprised our AHL team didn't start choking because of that. Let's check out our AHL squad. Let's see. So, Noah Douglas, 45 points. Nick Patan, 41. Matt Kern, 39. Jake Bean, the Green Bean line, man. Jake Bean, 34 points. I really hope he grows. I'm starting to think he was a waste of a trade. He needs to grow now, though. Andrew Kopp, Stahlberg, Dylan Dube. See, Stahlberg's about to pass him. That's kind of bad. Adam Mascherin's doing pretty good, too. He could be a fourth liner next season. We got to watch out, man. Luke Green, Chase DeLeo, Jack McFarland. Anybody like a high overall? Nope. Okay, awesome. Let me go put Christian Heljanko and as the starting goalie, that way we don't forget. We're going to take this to the All-Star game. I know this video is going to run really long. But you know what? I'm ready to win another Stanley Cup. I don't know about you guys. I'm ready to win another Stanley Cup and get on to a new team. I still say, what year are we in? Are we in 2021? Yeah, okay. We're in 2020 and 2021. So we can go a few more seasons. So we're going to play until... We're going to go to the All-Star game. The All-Star break. And then we'll deal with the trade deadline. Oh, we're on the All-Star break. Okay. We're going to go to the trade deadline then. I want to get some simulation rolling here. We're going to go to a few games before the trade deadline. We're going to see how the team looks. We are definitely going to slow sim the game against Chicago. Our team's actually, I need to upgrade their arena real fast. Let me do that, and I'll be back. Alright guys, back to some simulation. Again, we're going to slow some the game against Chicago. Here we go, the Florida Panthers. Ooh, we got a trade here. We have a trade. Let's take a look at this trade. It's from Arizona. McGinn? Is it Jeremy McGinn? Jamie McGinn. Why would we want Jamie McGinn for Jack McFarlane, who's a great prospect to have, and are another great prospect to have? We're going to just reject that. Oh, it's because they're on the trade block. I got you. Okay, let's keep the simulation rolling. Florida, 5-2 win. Hold up. This actually looks like an interesting trade here. That's Nick Foligno. I know Nick Foligno is pretty decent in this game. Nick Foligno is a 86 overall. Okay. 1 year left on his deal. For a third. But a first, though. A first. And a prospect. We can really. No. We don't need him. I'll pass on that trade. We don't need him. We're winning games. There's no reason in messing the team up now. Minnesota Wild. We will beat them 4-0. If we're winning a game, if it's not broke, don't fix it. I said that last time we got bounced first round. But you know what? I fixed that problem. Look at that. 4-1 win. We don't need Nick Foligno. Although he would be a great addition for... Where would we put him at? What? Is he going to play defense? No. We don't need Nick Foligno. Florida Panthers. Again, we will beat them 4-0. All right, guys. They updated our owner goals on the status of the team. So, advance to the Stanley Cup Final. That's going to be incredibly hard to do. I think we have the team to get there, and we beat Buffalo. We definitely have the team to do that, but that's an owner goal. So, that's going to be extremely hard to fulfill. If we don't get it, we can be in the hot seat. Another trade, we're not giving up our first-round pick at all. Decline that trade. There's no point in giving up our first-round pick. See, all these teams know we're a playoff team. That's why they're trying to get our first-round pick. New York Rangers, 2-0 win. 5-1 wins against Colorado Avalanche. Minnesota Wild, we lose to them, ending our long winning streak. How about that? Chicago, we were supposed to slow sim that game, weren't we? Oh, well. Detroit Red Wings, we will beat them 5-4. So, we'll continue simulation. And let's see here. Let's edit scout and assignment. Let's scout for some defensemen right here for 2 weeks. I don't want to trade the first round pick unless I know a giant trade is coming our way that is going to change the look of the team. Patrick Laine has something to say. He's at 87 overall now. He's still a second liner, so I mean he's not first line. What am I saying? I really think the team is okay. Let's be motivated. Okay, he likes that. He likes to be motivated. Okay. Extra minutes. You're 87 overall and you're a third liner and you're happy about it. Okay, let's be Joseph Quick. Let's be motivated. Nice. Everybody on our team likes common and motivated responses. So we may have to pay Joseph Quick some big money this offseason. It's a good thing we traded away some contracts. We do have a lot of salary cap available. That's why some teams are trying to trade us some 1 year guys. So here we go. We're just slow sim the game against the San Jose Sharks. And let's see where we go. We're on the trade deadline. We're not going to make any moves. We don't need to. There's no point in doing it. First period. Logan Couture, Josh Morrissey, Jansen Harkins, and Thomas Hurdle. Second period. Third period. Joseph Quick wins us the game. How about that? Joseph Quick, man. He's so good. He's just so good, man. Let's keep simulation rolling here. Montreal, and we're going to slow sim the game against New Jersey. That's going to be going into the trade deadline. We're 35-18-8. That's really good. So, Montreal Canadiens. We don't want Jeremy McGinn, and we do not want to give away any goalies. We will beat the Montreal Canadiens 2-1. We don't want Nick Foligno, man. Here we go. Let's slow sim this game against New Jersey. We are getting a lot of trades here by the deadline, though. This is the first trade deadline when we're actually getting trades sent to us. First period. Bastian and Cody McLeod. Second period. Or did I say Cody McLeod? I meant to say Michael McLeod. Adam Henrique. Third period. Josh Jacobs and Christian Vasilainen. that's a rough game. You know, those happen. Those happen. I'm not worried about it at all. Where do we sit in the standings? I'm going to say we're number two in the Central. We're number one in the Central Division by number points. Number of points. We actually passed St. Louis, man. I think we've played more games. Actually, yeah, we've played more games. Without a doubt, we've played more games. I can tell that for sure. How's our... I saw we put up a lot of points. Mark Scheifele only had 3 points in that span. No, okay, no, he had 13 points in that span. I was about to say, man, that's kind of terrible. Wow. Patrick Laine only scored 2 goals in that whole span of time. Really, man? All right, it might have been 3. Where's... Bjorkstrand picked it up. He scored 7 goals. That's better. That's what I want to see. Scheifele, Bergeron hasn't slowed down either. See, this is what I want to see. I want to see the whole team midway through the season up in 40 points. We're going to have some 70-point people. Like, Scheifele is going to hit 70 points this season. Laine could hit 60 to 70 points this season. I don't think he's going to hit 30 goals. Not this season. Yeah, he's not going to hit 30 goals this season. There's no way. 63 games, 16. He could do it. I'm going to be happy with 25 goals. I don't know. It took him 63 to get there. Anything's possible, man. Bergeron, doing great. Best free agent, or the best acquirement we could have done. We have Nylander, Blake Wheeler. Blake Wheeler is actually, could be a first liner again. Christian Vasilainen's growing. Joseph Quick is definitely going to be a second liner next offseason. We're going to have to sign him to some big money. I'm going to be okay with that. Because we can start slowly letting go of Blake Wheeler. He has 2 years left. We're going to play out his contract for 2 years. And yeah, hopefully he retires a Jet. And hopefully he's not going to be another Dustin Byfuglien situation. Because Joseph Quick's definitely moving up and can possibly in the next few seasons take Blake Wheeler's position. Bjorkstrand's going to be there as well. Bjorkstrand may be first liner next season. Blake Wheeler may be solidified second liner. Or he may go down in overall. You never know. The way this game is, Brendan Lemieux's doing decent. Josh Morrissey's doing pretty good. Jarrett McCann, Brett Halden. See, our team's gelling right now, man. Best player on the team, though, right now, as of right now, is... See, Jansen Harkin is going to win the Calder, without a doubt. We have 3 Calder nominees. Best player on the team, though... Eric Comrie, man, he's what's keeping us alive. 34, 14, and 5. That's pretty good. What's his goals again? 0.93 save percentage. That's really good. 7 shutouts. This guy is doing really good. If he keeps taking the starts like this, man, we're a Stanley Cup final team for sure. You know what? This video is going to be long. Let's finish the season. 1 month left. We're not going to make any moves. Trade deadline. Let's finish the season. Let's do this. Alrighty. Let's see what we can do. We may get a trade or something. One last chance at a trade. Send us something we can't refuse. Okay, he's updated. Okay, make first round of the play. I could do that. Want us to make round one of the playoffs. If we don't make the playoffs... then we're terrible, man. we're number one. I think it's because St. Louis must have started winning games. They're probably number one now. That's why. Yeah, they started. He's like, okay, I understand St. Louis is better. They may make Stanley Cup Finals. Make the first round. I'm going to be a happy camper. That's basically what happened right there. Yeah, let's get the season going, man. Let's finish the season out. I'm ready. Get you guys some playoff hockey again. The Washington Capitals 4-1 win. Let's go for the President's Trophy right now. Let's set season ticket prices. Let's lower the prices. Let's get some people and let's get some butts in seats, guys. They want to watch some playoff hockey coming up soon. Well, this is next season tickets, so they know we're going to be a playoff team next season as well, as we have such a young team. Might as well buy some tickets, guys. Come on. And that's going to be right there. Perfect. That should go well. Nope, we're good. I like the budget how it is, man. Toronto Maple Leafs. We will hopefully beat them 3-1. There we go. Now we're winning games, man. If we can keep winning games like this, as I said, we're for sure in the playoffs. Anyways, guys, we're definitely a playoff contender for sure. we're going to be like a late round. We're going to be in the late round of the playoffs, without a doubt. If we don't make the late round of the playoffs, I'm going to be highly disappointed. Like, if we're a first round exit, I'm going to be, I'm trading everybody. If we're a first round exit, everybody's gone. I'm buying out everybody's contracts, and we're signing all rookies. We just dropped three games straight, but you know what? I'm not worried about it. Because we're going to beat Edmonton, then we're going to beat Vancouver. Right? Nope. Okay. Come on. We just need to win the rest of these games. I don't want to be like, I don't want to go against St. Louis Blues in the first round of the playoffs. If we can avoid that, I will be a happy camper. Calgary, we will lose. Why are we losing games? Ugh, frustrating, man. There we go. 2-0 win over Central Division team. Pacific Division team, Calgary Flames. There we go. Now, okay, back-to-back wins. I'm happy now. Whew, okay, there we go. Now we're stringing the wins together. We are going to slow simulate this game against the Boston Bruins. See if Bergeron has some revenge for his old team. First period. Second period. Krejci and Bergeron. There we go, Bergie. Third period. Oh my gosh, why are we losing games? I shouldn't be worried about it, but it's bad that we're losing games. We're probably going down the rankings. See, now we're number three. So now, I mean, we're basically going to play the Dallas Stars. There's no way Colorado could catch us unless we do absolutely terrible rest of the season. I mean, I wanted to go for, like, the President's Trophy. Or at least, like, the division title. That's not going to happen. I mean, we're still in it. We are definitely still winning the division title. We are right there. Let's go for it. We can definitely, let's hunker down and do it, guys. And we have a big game against St. Louis and Colorado. So we need to win all these games to do it. I want to prove to the GM that, well, I want to prove to the owner that we're the GM that this team needs. And we lose another game. You got to be kidding me. At least beat New York. Shootout win, okay. We barely got the win, but we got a win. See, we're falling apart in the end. I don't like that. Why are we falling apart? Don't scare me like this, guys. 6-3 win, there we go. If we beat the Sharks, we're definitely in the division title talk. And we lose to the Sharks. It's because I say something. I think we're definitely in it, though. We're definitely in the division title talk. No, we're not. Oh, we technically still are. They haven't clinched it yet. Dallas is right there. So, let's see if we can still win the division. No, they have three games in hand. We gotta definitely beat them. If we can beat them, that's 2 points on them. So we need them to lose, and then we have to beat them. If they lose and we beat them, we can win it. But we also need the Dallas Stars to lose 2 games. It's gonna be tough, guys. It's gonna be a tough. This is a big game right here. We have to win both these games. Come on, guys. First period. Oh, my gosh. Second period. Come on. Really? You guys are really going to go into the playoffs like that? Well, we're not winning the division title. You know, okay. You know, I can't be mad. We made playoffs. We had a strong finish to the season. Come on. 5-0. 6-2. 5-0. There's no excuse for that. I know it's late in the season. And we made playoffs, but still, come on, win some games. Persani. Okay, we see. We're going back to falling apart in the third period. If we do that, we're a first round bounce again. For sure. I mean, look at this. March was terrible. I mean, we lost 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 games. I guess March. I mean, it's not a good month, though. Like, it could be so much better. And it's just whatever. We made playoffs. I'm happy, I guess. Not really. But you know what? I'm happy we made playoffs. Everybody's morale is going to go up because if we made it. Well, at least our AHL team finished first in the conference. That's always good. So we do have the Dallas Stars in the first round, as I predicted, because they were the second seed. Let's see if we at least pass them. I really hope we at least pass them. Let's check out the points, though. All right, points on the season. Mark Scheifele, 72. I believe he tied his all-time high. No, he missed it by 2 points. But you know what? I can't be mad. He's a plus 32 last season? Really? We were balanced first round? I don't see how. I can't be mad, dude. Mark Schlafly had a great season. He scored. Did he? Yeah, he surpassed his goal total. Wow, he had 20. He nearly had a 30 goal season that year. Patrick Laine hit 22 goals. Didn't hit the limit I gave him, but look how many points he got, man. 66 points. Not as much as last year, but you know what? Last year was a great year. 17. Wow, man. Why are you struggling to score goals all over? I'm not mad. You know what? No, Bergeron almost had a 30-goal season, though. At least we have at least one nearly 30-goal season. Blake Wheeler, Bergeron, Nylander, Joseph Quick, man. This guy's a stud. He's going to be so good for us. We definitely got to lock him up long-term while we still can this upcoming offseason. Jensen Harkins is at 84. He may be a second-line center before sooner than we think. We may have to watch out for him and Joseph Quick. They're going to gain morale extremely fast. Christian Vasilainen, he could be a second liner too. So we may be running into some trouble again like last season. Too many centers. Not enough left wings. Too many centers and right wings. Brendan Lemieux did pretty good. Josh Morrissey, 28 points. Brett Howden, 27 points. Jarrett McCann, 26. Tyler Myers, 18. Jacob Chuba, 8. Jacob Chuba finally putting up some points, man. Thank you, Jacob Chuba. Most points you put up in a while. Thank you, man. You're finally helping the team. You're contributing. Even though you're locked at 86, I appreciate you. Darcy Persani, Logan Stanley, Brendan Carlo, and that's it. So, hats off to our goalie, though, because he's the reason why we're this far into the season. 43-24-5. What a record. 0.93 save percentage. Not bad. Connor Hellebuyck didn't really play many games. So, yeah. That's that. And let's check out the points for the whole league. I didn't do that last time. And some people commented, hey, man, you have to do that. We want to see everybody. So, here's the entire league. Maybe we had some people. No, Vladimir Tarasenko and Jaden Schwartz, man. That's a dangerous 1-2 punch. See, we need to get some. We need a 1-2 punch like that. And Paul Stastny. Jeez, man. That's their first line. All over a point per game player. Tarasenko, Schwartz, Tavares, Stastny, Kane, Reinhardt getting up there now. Puljujärvi, Voracek, Kopitar, Klingberg, Panarin, Atkinson, Claude Giroux, Jonathan Toews, Jamie Benn, Jack Eichel, Steven Stamkos, Johnny Gaudreau, Tyler Toffoli, David Krejci, Tyler Seguin, Mark Scheifele, Michael Dowell, Cole. Goal scoring, we got Tarasenko, Stamkos, Nathan MacKinnon, Jack Eichel, Patrick Kane, Sam Reinhart, Jonathan Tavares, Mark Stone, Michael Dowell, Cole, Jamie Benn, Claude Giroux, Tyler Toffoli, Jakub Voracek, Phil Kessel. Okay! Best plus minus in the league, not that it matters, Ryan Pulock. Let's see who's taking home the Calder this year. It's not going to be one of our guys, that's for sure. This guy, Julius Natinen. Jeez, 58 points, man. And then Ross Brody. I think that was like the fifth overall pick. It was. That was the guy I considered trading up for, but we didn't. Man, that would have been great. I mean, he probably played on a really OP line. Matthew Phillips, 49 points. Nick Merkley, John Sweeney, Rourke. Cherrier, Andrzej Szkierak, and then Jansen Harkins. Fortunately, Jansen Harkins will not take home the Calder. I believe that Natinen guy definitely will, for sure. Unless there's a goalie that could take it home. I highly doubt they give it to the goalie. Zachary Fucali could actually take it, though. No, he can't, though. Not 6-10, that's for sure. This guy could. That is. Okay. Is that really Dallas's goalie, Rusu? Really, is a 78 overall, and we got Dallas in the playoffs. Ooh, I'm ready for this series, guys. I'm so ready for this upcoming series. So yeah, let's see where we finished in the league, and I'm gonna end the video there, guys. Get ready for some playoffs. How'd Dallas finish so high? If that's our goal, they must have a good starter goalie. So we did finish 7th in the NHL. Who finished dead last? I was hoping it would be Boston because we had their second round pick, but it was the Devils, San Jose. Where's Boston at? Did they make playoffs? Yeah, they made playoffs. So they actually finished. Where's Boston? Boston. I don't see Boston. Oh, they're right there. They missed the playoffs. Okay, good. So they're in the draft lottery, so maybe their second round pick could be pretty good. We didn't even break 100 points. Last season, we were up there for the President's Trophy. We didn't break 100 points this season. But you know what? Whatever. We're in the playoffs. We're going to win the Cups. The fans are happy. The owner's happy. I'm happy. You're happy. Everybody's happy. If you did enjoy this video, press that like button down below. Comment anything. I mean, I'm going to record the playoffs now, so there's no point in commenting. But you can comment and tell me what your opinion on the trades were. I know some people are going to disagree with the Bergeron trade, but hey, man, it worked. You're just sitting there saying, oh, Bergeron should not be a Winnipeg Jet. He should have retired a Boston Bruin. They had him on the block, and guess what? It worked. He wants another Stanley Cup ring. We'll win it for him, that's for sure. We have the team to do it. Nobody's going to argue with us. We have the team to do it. If anybody can do it, we can. Look at our AHL team, man. They're making a playoff run, too. That's great. Man. All right. See you guys in the next video. Also, thanks for 50,000 views. And if you made it this far in the video, give yourself a round of applause. This is a long video. See you guys in the playoffs.